Hi, I'm Stu from Hivemind Automation and welcome to The Hive. In this video, we'll be taking a look at this three pack of Nanoleaf Essentials A60B22 Matter Globes. As always, we'll take a look around the outside of the box. We'll get them out of the box. We'll set them up using the native methods. And being that they are matter, we might even get time to set one of them up in Home Assistant. So while I roll the intro, why don't you take a moment to subscribe? And if you hit the bell icon, you'll get notified when I release new videos, which is normally each week. While you're at it, if you like what I do here and you want to support the channel, there's affiliate links to smart home gadgets that you can buy for your own smart home and support the channel at the same time without costing you any extra. Or you can support the channel directly through my Buy Me a Coffee link. Of course, those affiliate links and my Buy Me a Coffee link can all be found on my website, hivemindautomation.com.au. With all of that out of the way, let's get started. So a couple of weeks ago, we were at Officeworks to pick up some bits and pieces to organize some of our old documents. And while we were there, I figured I'd see what they had in their smart device section. And I saw this pack of three Nanoleaf Matter smart light bulbs on clearance for $39. Now for context, a single Nanoleaf Essentials Matter smart bulb is priced at $35. So $4 extra for an additional two bulbs is a bargain. And the three pack is normally $99 on Amazon. That said, I'm a little concerned that they're on clearance because that might be an indication that they're not going to be stocking the three pack anymore, or maybe there's a new version due out soon. That said, if you can't find them at your Officeworks for this amazing price, I will put an Amazon affiliate link in the description to the normal price. Unfortunately, I can't pass that $39 on to you though. Now, I've reviewed a Nanoleaf light bulb in the past, but it wasn't the matter version of the Essentials bulb. So I will be interested to see if there's any real difference between them, but I don't think there's going to be much. Now, in terms of prerequisites, these Nanoleaf Matter bulbs are going to connect over a Thread network. So while for the first time in a little while, we don't need a 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi network, we do need a Matter over Thread border router. Now, in my case, we've got a HomePod mini right behind me. We've also got an Apple TV 4K third generation and some other devices that can operate as a Matter border router as well, like our Google Nest Hub. I will see if I can find a comprehensive list of Matter border routers, and if I can do that, I'll put a link in the video description below. Something else that you should be aware of is that with Matter, during the provisioning of the device, there will be a Bluetooth connection as well. So you do need to have Bluetooth turned on your mobile device while you are pairing the accessory. But after that initial provisioning, the Bluetooth shouldn't actually be used anymore for any of the control signaling. That's all happening over Thread. So as always, let's begin with a quick look around the outside of the box. Now on the front, we've got the Nanoleaf logo, Smarter by Design, three bulbs, Essentials Matter Smart Bulb, A60B22, color temperature and 16 million colors, Matter, Apple Home, Google Home, a picture of the bulbs. On the right, we have a serving suggestion. On the left, 806 lumens brightness, 1 to 100% dimming, 25,000 hours lifespan, rated power 9 watts, rated input 220 to 240 volts AC at 50 to 60 hertz, color channels 2700K to 6500K and RGB CW, dimmable with app, dimensions are 6 centimeters by 11 centimeters, versatile control, light switch, voice, app, mobile and desktop, model is NL6B200, and there's some EU energy rating data here, Matter, built on Thread, requires border router, Bluetooth, works with Apple Home, works with Google Home, works with Razer Chroma, the Nanoleaf app logo, download on the App Store, get it on Google Play, and on the back, fast and reliable with new Thread network technology, schedules for personalized lighting automation, motion, dynamic scenes for color changing animations, circadian lighting to sync with your body's natural clock. Matter enabled devices support interoperability with other Matter certified devices and platforms, including Apple Home, Google Assistant, Amazon Alexa, and more. For latest Matter compatibility requirements, please visit nanoleaf.me/matter. The Nanoleaf social media links there. On the top is just the Nanoleaf logo with the Smarter by Design tagline there. And on the bottom, this Matter certified accessory requires an Apple Home Hub, such as a HomePod, HomePod Mini, or Apple TV 4th generation or later, with all Apple devices running the latest software. Do not dispose in unsorted waste. Hidden here is the CRI rating of 90, which is quite good, and a PNET of 0.3, I'm not sure what that is. Some disposal compliance logos. And if we spin it around, the manufacturer details there with their addresses in Toronto, Paris, and Hong Kong. With the outside covered off, let's open it up and see what's inside the box. I started by cutting the plastic dot, sealing the top edge, and just used a spudger here to try and open the box without tearing it. As we open up the top flaps, we're greeted by some paperwork. This little booklet has a QR code in the front to the user manual and warranty registration. It's got some warnings and disposal information in a number of different languages. We've then got this sticker, which has the three Matter pairing codes printed, both with a QR code and the human readable code there, the serial numbers and the IDs of each of the three bulbs. Taking this cardboard separator out, we then get to the bulbs themselves. And if I take one out, we can see that, like last time we looked at Nanoleaf Essentials bulbs, we've got this faceted design of the bulb, which I personally think is pretty nice, as well as being an interesting point of difference between Nanoleaf and other manufacturers. We've got the same Matter pairing codes etched on the sides of the bulbs, along with some other branding specs and warnings here. Unsurprisingly for Nanoleaf, the build quality feels pretty great. Everything feels like there's been a really good level of quality control. As you'd expect, all three bulbs tell the same story. If I dig further into the box, there's nothing else in there, so it's pretty minimalist in the box there. Three bulbs, a sticker with pairing codes, and a little booklet. So with the bulbs out of the box, let's get these set up. Before we do that though, the Train and Hobby Show is back for 2024, and it's only a few short weeks away on the 16th and 17th of March at Sandown Racecourse and Entertainment Centre. There'll be makers, arts and crafts, model railways, radio control models, ham radio and electronics, computing and home automation, and for the very first time this year, we've also got trading cards and pop culture coming to the Train and Hobby Show. I'll be at the Train and Hobby Show again for 2024, showcasing smart home gadgets and home automation using Home Assistant. Tickets are available on the website, and it's sure to be a great family day out. If you want to come along, head to the website trainandhobbyshow.com.au. That's TRAINANDHOBBYSHOW.com.au. And now back to the Nanoleaf Matter bulbs. So I'm only going to pair up one of these bulbs for now, and I'll do that in the Hive Apartments here. I've just turned on the power and we get this warm white default out of it, so these would probably work just fine as a dumb bulb if you really wanted to, provided they're not on a dimmer switch. To set these up, I'm going to start with Apple Home. And as always, I'll tap the plus button in the top right-hand corner and then add accessory. When I'm prompted to scan a setup code, I made sure that I put the top one in the apartment here, so I'll scan the top setup code from the sticker that we found in the box. It's detected that it's a light, it's connecting, it's setting up, and it's adding to home. We're then prompted to choose a room to put it in. I'm going to put this one in the office. And then we can give it a name. I'll call this one Nanoleaf 1 for now. We get an option to add some automations here for when the first person arrives home, the last person leaves home, or because I have a motion sensor in my office, there's also an option here to turn the light on when motion is detected. If I didn't have that motion sensor in that office room, it wouldn't show this automation as a possibility. I will leave these alone and I'll tap continue. We get light added to the Hive, and then we can tap either done or view in home. I'll tap view in home and we'll go straight to the controls for the light. And we can control it using the brightness slider here. And as always, we can tap the quick color selectors at the bottom. Now the strobing effect we see on camera here is an artifact of the camera. I did quickly adjust my camera settings and they went away. I will say that some of the color settings didn't work particularly well from Apple Home. Some of the cool white colors were just plain blue, which seemed a bit odd, but not really a big deal. We'll see a bit later that I need to run a firmware update on this bulb, which has a decent chance of fixing that, I hope. That said, I'm unlikely to be using Apple Home to control these lights anyway, other than putting them into a good night scene to turn them off. As always in HomeKit, we've got the color selector as well to use the color picker or the temperature selector and define new favorites from here as well. From the main control screen, we'll tap the cog in the bottom right corner and we get the settings where we can change the name, change the room that we're in if we want, add or remove from the home view, include in favorites. We can group with other accessories, which in the case of this 3-pack might be useful if you were maybe installing them in one of those older style decorative light fixtures that takes 3 or more bulbs and then you turn them all on or off at once. This should also then group the color functions as well. We have the 3 automations that we saw before that we can turn on or off. In suggested scenes, we can add it to any of these scenes here, including the good night scene. And by default, it figures out that we'd probably want to turn the bulb off in that good night scene. We've got the status section here and we can include in home summaries. And then lastly, as always, we've got the manufacturer section with a link to the NanoLeaf app. And if we didn't have the NanoLeaf app installed, that would be an install link instead of an open link. There's the manufacturer name, NanoLeaf, obviously. The serial number, the model number, firmware version, and there's, as always, we've got the remove accessory link, but right above the remove accessory link, we've got something a bit different here, this turn on pairing mode link, which I believe is specific to Matter devices, and we'll see how that works a little bit later on too. We would use this if we were trying to do multi-admin and allow someone else access to our Matter device to be able to turn it on and off. I'm going to tap open next to the NanoLeaf app to pop over to the NanoLeaf app. And from the home page, we can scroll through and we see we've already got the NanoLeaf 1 bulb included in here. If I drill in, we've got most of the same controls like a color picker and a brightness slider, but we've also got this scenes tab and there's not much in there just yet, but we'll fix that in just a moment. If we go to the favorites tab, there's nothing in there at the moment either. So we'll head back to scenes. And when I tap the magic wand button in the top right, we get this prompt to complete setup. It says you've set up your light in another app. Complete the setup to access all features. When I tap continue on that prompt, we get a before you start screen telling us to make sure Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and power are on. And there's at the bottom an option to either scan the QR code or use a pairing code. Now in my case, I tapped use pairing code and it started scanning for devices. And while it was doing that, popped back over to Apple Home and tapped the turn on pairing mode link. And then I tapped copy code. When I went back to the NanoLeaf app after a few moments, the NanoLeaf bulb showed up. I was able to tap pair next to it. I was prompted for the pairing code and I pasted the one that I copied from HomeKit in here, but it told me that it was the incorrect pairing code. So I decided I'd try manually typing in the pairing code that we saw on the sticker before, which ended up working. We get these checkboxes to say it found the thread network and added the device to it. It managed to pull the device name and the room correctly from the device. And after a moment, it also then popped up this critical firmware update available banner. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to action anything here. After hitting the color scenes tile here though, I was taken back to the scenes page where I was greeted with a lot more scenes that I can enable for the light, including animated slow fades and other animated effects. Back on the basic page, I played around a little bit more with some of the color temperature settings and the brightness slider just to see how responsive it was, and it was very responsive. Tapping the sliders icon in the top right hand corner to get to settings, we can see some more info in here and we can turn on things like power loss recovery, which will restore the last known state of the light if you lose power and then it comes back on a bit later. There's the connect to Matter section here, which is already connected to Apple Home. And there's a big red disconnect button there, which I'm not going to touch right now. And then there's all the details that we've kind of already seen here before, like the name, the default name, there's the serial number, the model number, the firmware version, the hardware version, the connection type, and the thread network that it's connected to. And we've got an identify and a delete button at the bottom here as well. Now, strangely, the firmware update isn't available from this settings menu either though, which I'm a little bit weirded out by. However, when I backed out of the device controls, I was in the My Devices menu with the NanoLeaf 1 listed with an update tile underneath it. I backed out of this menu just to figure out where I was in the interface, and it turns out that I was on the More page from the bottom of the screen and in My Devices. When I returned to the My Devices menu, I immediately was prompted with the critical update, a critical security and performance update is required for your lights to function properly. Please keep your app open and mobile device in the same room as your Essentials lights during the update. I tapped update on here and then I was prompted with Essentials update. For optimal speed, please ensure the mobile device is in the same room as the Essentials device during the update. When I tapped continue, the update proceeded as expected and it took just under 5 minutes. After the update was completed, the light took a moment to reconnect and I saw this Bluetooth logo for a moment and then the Thread logo popped up very shortly after. From the three dot stack next to the globe, I can tap settings, which takes me back into the settings that we saw before, and there's other things we can do from that three dot stack as well. Now, I have tried pairing this bulb to Home Assistant. Unfortunately, even though it is a Matter bulb, I am having a bit of trouble with getting it paired. Not entirely sure what is going on. I will need to explore that further, but rather than waste your time and have this video run massively over time, I will save the explorations of Matter in Home Assistant for a future video. I might just have to do a full-on deep dive into Matter and Home Assistant separately. So that is my three pack of NanoLeaf Essentials A60 B22 Matter Globes. Considering I picked up this three pack on clearance for $39, I feel like I got an absolute bargain. The color output of these globes is pretty nice and the build quality is good as well. Because they're Matter, they theoretically should work with any smart home setup. Being Matter over Thread should also make them responsive and reliable, as Thread networks are supposed to be able to self-heal. There's still some frustrations with Matter and Thread in their current versions, but for the most part, I believe personally that these standards are pushing the industry in the right direction. As always, let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. That's all we have for this video, and I hope that it helped you in your home automation journey. Be sure to drop a comment below with a home automation idea you'd like to see me cover in a future video. And don't forget to follow HiveMind Automation on Instagram and Facebook. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button down below to give it a like. And if you're not already subscribed, please consider changing that now by hitting the subscribe button. And while you're at it, if you hit the bell icon, you'll get notified when I release new videos, which is normally each week. Lastly, if you like what I'm doing here and you want to help support the channel, there's a Buy Me a Coffee link in the video description below. Any contribution you make through Buy Me a Coffee does get put towards making more and hopefully better content for you to enjoy. Don't forget to check out my website, hivemindautomation.com.au. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Stu from HiveMind Automation and I'm looking forward to seeing you next time. Bye for now.